Hey guys, what's going on? So you guys probably checked out some of my videos, and one of them was about the cash trap original. So I'm here today to show you guys how to do cash trap 2.0. A lot of us have been really successful. As you see, Matthew Fire, he's been extremely successful. Cash trap, the original, did really well for myself and my team. We made some great money from there. And the fact that cash trap 2.0 came out and had so many add-ons for us to like level up and just to train the eye so we can become great traders. So I'm going to go through cash trap 2.0 and show you some tips and what things that I go through also to check to make sure, like, you know, oh shoot, I can also have done this to get into that and a little bit more of a confirmation. So today is Saturday. It is December 26, 2020. We're about to hit 2021. So the market is closed, but I'm going to go into cash trap. I do have some slides to show you the alert panel, because obviously cash trap alert panel won't be running right now because the markets are closed. There's no alerts, but I do have something to show you exactly what to look for. So do not worry. Let me share my screen. Awesome sauce. All right. Let's actually turn down this music so you can hear me. Okay, first things first. So if you've been through my videos, you know I go to forexfactory.com. The reason why I go here is because I need to check for the day that what I'm going in. So just say today is Wednesday, which is not, it's Saturday. And we decided to say, okay, we're ready for trades. Let me check what's going on here. No red flags. If you see a red folder, not flags, red folder, please do not go in for any trades. Even if it's gray, I believe you see a gray one. Banks are usually closed or some type of holiday. Do not trade with that currency. There's no point, because it's not going to be going how you would want it to go, where you think it's supposed to be going. Trade with only the orange or the yellow. That's the only ones you want to be going in for. Okay. Now, the next thing is the currency strength meter. Call me old school. I do not care. This is what I like. I know Cash Trap 2.0 carries the currency strength meter in the alert panel, which we'll go through. But I just kind of want to show you guys the breakdown of like how it is, okay? And I still do this before I go in for every trade. So just say we are looking at Euro USD. And Euro USD, there is 3 bars, and USD has 4 bars. So when you look at something like this, you need to find out which one is stronger. So Euro has 3, USD has 4. So that means that USD is stronger than Euro. Another thing to look for is, how do you know which one's the buy and which one's the sell? This is how. The first one is always a buy. The second one is always a sell. Always remember that. So Euro is going to be the buy and USD is going to be the sell. Okay, you guys. So the first one's always the buy. The second one is always the sell. Another thing to look for. If the bars are equal, or even on the alert that they are equal, you do not want to go in for a trade. Personally, you guys, okay, you see how AUD has 5 bars? And do you see how CAD has 3 bars? I would do a trade like this. I like some separation in strength. I like to know we're more dominant over here. So that means I'm going to be going in for these. So just say if it was AUD CAD, AUD is a buy. CAD would have been a sell. AUD has 5 bars. CAD has 3 bars. That means that I'm going to go in for buys. Don't get it twisted. You have the ability to also go in for sells. But because we're on a checkmark system, we want to make sure that we have enough confirmations for us to be going in. So the first one, we're going to go through all this whole point system and how you can use it in so many different ways. And you're going to love it. Once you train your eye, you're going to be like, wow, this is amazing. It's going to be so easy for wins that when you lose, you're going to be like, wow, how did this happen? Literally, because winning should become really easy because it's very instruction basis. As long as you can read and you know how to press a red and a green button, wins, wins, wins. All right, here we go. Let's go into the cash trap. So as we talked about, the alert panel is not up. Don't be alarmed. I have something to help us right here, and we will go through all of that. So this is the point system. There are 7 confirmations for us to go in. If you look over here to the left, it says good trade, 3 points, better trade, 4 points, and best trade is 5 plus points. Personally, you guys, if it ain't four or more, I am not going in. I'm not going in off 3 points. That's not enough for me, especially if you're on a compound. You're on your third compound. That's crazy to me. That's a lot of money that you're putting in there and not even having enough confirmation knowing that you should be going in for this trade, right? So personally, like I said, four and plus trades to be going on with confirmations. Now, let's go through these point systems, and then after we'll go through the graphs so you can understand, okay? And we'll also go through the alert panel so you know how what to look for. Okay, the first part, if just say this is a call, and then this is the put. So the call is a buy, you guys. Don't get confused, right? So remember, the green button means call, and it also means buy, okay? The sell, the red button means sell and put, okay? So let's go back and talk about the call and the buy, same thing. So a green arrow, this means that the computer is generating and letting us know every 5 minutes when to go in for a trade. So just say right now it is 5:50. So 5:50, a new trade setup will be happening and letting us know when to be going in, giving us either a green arrow or a red arrow, letting us know with an entry price and also the time that it just started for a new setup, which we'll go over. So the green arrow is 1 point. That's letting us know that we can go in for a buy, but that isn't enough. The second part is the currency strength meter. Which one is stronger? So if we're going in for Euro USD, just say, and Euro had a stronger than USD, that means we will be going in for Euro. Check mark, that would have been 2 points. A next check mark would be price at green Bollinger band line, 1 point, which we'll go over with the graphing. The next part is price at green support line, which is very new, you guys. Cashtrap One did not have these support lines, which is pretty awesome. They also didn't have the currency strength meter either. So that's also a new thing. But like I said, you guys, I still go into the currency strength meter with the UK live charts, whatever. Another good thing is the overbought. Yes, so if a B pops up for the stochastics, this is mean that it has been overbought and that we have the ability letting us know that the stochastic is ready, in which I'm going to show you how all the indicators work. The next thing is if it crosses up through the green line. So you remember how it crosses down and then back up, that's an indication of a setup that is ready, which we will go through as well. That is for stochastics. And the same for stochastic is RSI crossing down on the green line and up. Here, the only thing different is also the red arrow and the S for the oversold, meaning crossing up on the red, crossing back down. That will give us an S, letting us know that the stochastics is strong, which we'll be going over. Okay, the next part is the alert panel, which is very important, you guys. The alert panel lets us know pretty much what to be looking for and training our eyes to get also ready. So we know, we just say we're watching USD CAD. So the symbol is USD CAD right over here. It will let us know the type, meaning when to go in for the trade. So either a put or a call. Remember, a put means sell, which is the red button, and then a call means buy, which is the green button. Always remember, you don't want to press the wrong button. Also for these trade-ups, it's a 3-minute trade setup. So from the time, again, you guys, another tip, these are gems. I personally wouldn't go in after 60 seconds. So each candle is worth 5 minutes and a new setup will happen, which a new candle will appear. And then either a red arrow will pop down or a green arrow will pop up. And this is how you know you should be going in for a new setup with also other confirmations. So please watch out for that and do not go in after 1 minute. So if you're going in for a trade, if 60 seconds have passed, I personally wouldn't go in. I would wait for a new setup, all my confirmations aligning, and then I would either be hitting my red button or my green button for 3 minutes and going in for a trade and hopefully winning the bag because I have all these confirmations ready to go. All right, the next part is the entry. Why the entry is very important, okay, you guys? The entry is important because it may not be dead on stamp where it's like, oh my God, it's the exact same number, but it gives you an idea where you need to be looking at your broker. So if it's telling us to go in at last three digits, always watch the last three digits, you guys. So if it's telling us to go in at 317, We want to stay close to that. And it's telling us it's a put. So really 318, even on a higher number, because we caught it a little higher for it to drop down, that's golden too. I would prefer to stay in 2 to 3 points, like off of the entry, what Cash Trap is giving us. Another cool thing was the currency pair, you guys. So you guys see right here, USD CAD. It's telling us what is happening here because it did tell us to go in for a put. So what does that mean? That obviously CAD should be stronger. You know what I mean? Like if it's going to be a proper confirmation all the way through, because it can give you a call, but you know, you don't have all your check marks unless you have more than 4+ to be going in. So USD is giving us 14 in the currency pair and CAD is 38. So because CAD is stronger than USD, what does this mean? This means that we want to be looking for only sells. So because CAD is stronger. Another thing is the time. It's letting us know how much time has passed since this trade alert has been given. So it states here that 2 minutes have passed. So remember, the candles are 5 minutes. 2 minutes have passed. That means there's 3 minutes left on this candle. Personally, I would not go in for a trade unless it says 1 minute has passed. That means I will be going in for this trade setup if I had all my confirmations. Cool. I hope we're up to date with this. This is the cool alert panel. Now, let's see. We talked about all of this. Let's head over to Cash Trap. So you guys, Cash Trap is pretty amazing with all the new things that we said that we were looking for setups. So imagine we are looking for a sell, okay? We said we're in USD CAD. Just imagine, okay? So we said that CAD is stronger. So we need to be looking for sell confirmations. And how do we look for that? Let me show you, okay? So now just say this is the red Bollinger Band. So you guys, this is the Bollinger Band right here. This red line right here. This middle line right here and this green line. The middle line represents the moving average. So like I like to look at this is if my candles are above this moving average or even going above kind of slightly through, we're in a seller zone. If it's below, we're in a buyer's zone. So this is where you another eye thing to watch for. So let's talk about some confirmations, right? How do we know to go in for a sell? This is how. So here is our candle. Our candle, we're going to look at this one right here. Actually, do we have a better setup? Let's see. One that's touching resistance. Let's look for a good one. I just want like a perfect one, you know? This one's close enough. Okay, let me show you how this one looks like, okay, you guys? So here's this candle, right? This candle is touching the red Bollinger Band. That is a check mark. One, we said that the currency pair was in a seller's market with USD CAD, right? So that would have been two check marks. Then we have, see this red line right here? That is resistance. That is the ceiling. And then the green is the floor. Very important, because remember, we have sometimes higher highs, higher lows. We may have some consolidations, but we now need to know where price is moving up and down. And this is where you can watch your market, okay? So if your candle is touching a resistance line, which is a Bollinger Band, which is one, we already knew the currency pair we had was strong, which is two. Then we had it touching a resistant line. Then it was three. Ugh, this is crazy, right? So that's 3 points, but we're not done here yet. What if an arrow popped up and it was a red arrow pushing down? That is four, right? Remember, four good trades to me is a banger. But we weren't done there though. There's stochastics and RSI. And let me tell you how this works so we can grab another point right here. So if price is going above oversold for this black line and crossing back down right over here, that is another indication as a confirmation for you to go in. So that would make you five. Now, if the RSI was following that same thing, that gave you six confirmations. Remember, there's only seven and it gave you six. If it gave you six, that is a win-win. Like that is like, woo, 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 guaranteed. So that's what I look for, you guys. To me, I don't rush this. This is not a get rich scheme thing. This is me training my eye, watching my candles, watching the Bollinger Bands, watching the support and my resistance, looking at my stochastics, looking at my RSI, then watching with the arrow and going over. And I know this seems crazy, but if you keep doing this and paying attention, wins become so easy. The losses are going to be like shock, because at this point it's instruction basis. All you have to do is say, okay, okay, okay. And when you have those things, and I know we all get a little rushed because we want to go in a little faster, spend an hour. That's all you need. You go in for an hour in the morning or an hour after you're done work. We're not expecting you guys to quit your jobs and say, oh my God, I'm going to get rich off cash trap. No, we want you to grow and learn. We want you to learn this strategy, see how it is to go in for a trade, then apply it even on TradingView, then go in for snipes with a 1 minute and a 3 minute on candles. And then from there to even go faster, and you're moving faster because your eye's trained. But the whole thing why Matthew Thayer made this is to give beginner traders the ability to trade and make money with their families, generational wealth. So like I said, you guys, the cash trap point system is right here. It's amazing. Then after the alert panel, we already went through everything. Remember, the market closes Friday at 5 p.m. and reopens Sunday at 5 p.m. Personally, I don't like to trade on Sundays. I prefer Mondays. And even when I go on Mondays, they're really light. Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursdays are my favorite. And Friday mornings, if I can catch a bang out in the morning, which I'm never rushing if a setup ain't there, I'm not rushing it. I've been had my losses and I've had some great wins, and I want to stay consistent with my wins. And I realize staying consistent with your wins is literally following the point system. And it's right here. It's literally check mark. Okay, I got that arrow. I know that this one's stronger. It is touching a Bollinger Band. It is touching my support and resistance. A B popped up to show me that it's an overbought. I got a line crossing over and crossing back down from my stochastics, crossing up and crossing back up, I mean. And that also goes through my RSI. And that's enough, you guys. It doesn't have to be this complicated, literally. Never has to be. It's pretty awesome. So I feel like if we just kind of just follow these instruction bases, we can go so far. Anybody can learn. A 10-year-old up into an 80-year-old has the ability. As long as you can read and follow instructions, you have the ability to make great money for yourself, for your family, your loved ones, making generational wealth. It is absolutely amazing, you guys. Like, cash trap has like totally changed a lot of people's lives, including myself, and have made me just grow and to be a better trader. So if you're not even a part of IAM Academy, make sure you sign up. If you want to come over and let me show you, send me a message and I can show you exactly how we can make some money together and grow and be great traders and impact different in other people's lives off just a strategy from a computer, just to help you guys out and myself again. So like I said, these are the Bollinger Bands right here, the red, the green, and the middle for the moving average. The red lines on the top are the support and the resistance. Did you guys see ceiling and floor? And over here is oversold, when your line is crossing above the red and crossing back down. And RSI is the same. You want it to be crossing on the oversold. That's the red dotted line. That's the oversold. And then when you want it to be crossing on the overbought, the coming crossing down and crossing back up, this is a perfect setup right in here when you see that, right? This is what we want for check marks. And then if the B pops up or a S, did an S pop up anywhere? So you can see it. Oops. My mouse wants to do some weird stuff. There you go. And S popping up right over there, then you know that is for the oversold. So you guys, I'm glad you guys have taken time to watch my video on Cash Trap 2.0. Cash Trap 2.0 original is on my old videos. You can catch up some of my trading view setups, how I go in on a 1 minute and a 3 minute. That is also there. If you guys need any help on pocket options, that is also there in my channel. So you guys can check that out. Thank you so much. Also, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. If you guys have any questions or want me to go over through any other videos or just want me to talk on just maybe just a specific indicator, let me know and I'll be gladly to make a video for you guys. Enjoy the rest of your holidays. Like I said, it's December 26, 2020. Let's make the best of it because 2021 is going to be exceptionally amazing because you made it amazing. Bye, you guys.